ask everybody to kind of move this way, if you wouldn't mind. First of all, welcome and thank you for coming out. It's kind of fun to look into the crowd. It looks like a group of friends more than a crowd, so I appreciate that. I would tell you, had this project been on time, you'd all be standing in the snow. So we can be grateful for the fact that it wasn't on time. I've had several people ask me, you know, if it's frustrating to me that, you know, this was supposed to start in November and, you know, now it's May. And the fact of the matter is, you know, 4 or 5 months is a short period of time when the conversation's been going on for 10 years. So 5 more months didn't really seem like a long time to me, but it probably did to you all and probably to some of our physicians and patients. So it really didn't. Today probably marks one of the last times I get to ask or answer the question, hey, why does Avera have 2 family medicine clinics in Spirit Lake? So I'll be happy not to answer that question, and I won't attempt to answer it for you now because it's kind of a long story. But I won't have to answer that question again. I think the other commitment that I think we'll finally be able to meet is every physician, so I've been here 10 years, every physician that we've recruited since I've been here, we've said someday you'll share a call. Someday you'll be a combined group, and someday you'll all be under some roof, the same roof. Well, today is someday. So I'm excited about that. So today really marks the start or the end of a 10-year conversation about the combination of the two groups. And I think what this will allow us to do is we'll create an enhanced care experience for the patients. I think we'll create a better environment for recruiting and retaining physicians, not just physicians, nurses, lab staff, business office staff. We're very, very excited about that. And I think the new medical office building will give us a more flexible environment as the healthcare system dynamic changes. Secondarily to that, for those that aren't aware, it will dramatically change the west side entrance to the hospital. It will give an appearance of a hospital and not an elementary school. If we have many people that pass by the hospital and say, hey, we missed the hospital. I said, really, you missed the big sign out front? Oh, we thought it was an elementary school. I said, we'll work on the front presence of that. So this project, and you're standing what will be adjacent to it, this project is an $8 million project. It'll take about 14 months. And I'm really excited. There are 20 different contractors that'll be working on this project, many of which are local contractors. We had many local services that were part of the planning process, and so we're excited about that part of it. I would tell you that today's not about buildings, however. Today's really about people. You know, buildings and equipment and otherwise are tools for healthcare professionals to take care of patients, to take care of our friends, neighbors, and the community. So I often talk about buildings is like being similar to the church. When people talk about the power of the church, they're not talking about a building, they're talking about the people in the building. And so today's really a celebration of about people and not about a building. Buildings are symbolic of the past, and they really speak toward the future, and we're gonna talk about that today. Part of that celebration is acknowledging the past. So the building to my right, to your left, Spirit Lake Medical Center, I actually received confirmation 5 minutes ago from Dr. Ford that building actually opened in 1976. I'd heard anywhere between 1972 and 1975. So I roughly figured out in 45 years, there was between 750,000 and 1 million patient visits that occurred in that building. So pretty impressive that there are physicians and nurses and lab staff and others and patients that had all of their care delivered or they delivered it in that building over their career. And so some of them are here, and I think it's worth noting and acknowledging that. But in all this, some of these physicians are retired, some of them still here. Unfortunately, in one of their instances, one of them has passed. But I think it's a good time to tell a quick story. So Spirit Lake Medical Center, Dr. Brian Ford is retired. Dr. Ford is with us. Dr. Maury Curlin, retired, is also with us. Dr. Don Rodwig is not able to be here. Dr. Don's dad was also a physician here. Dr. Jeff Gores is with us. Dr. Gores spent all of his career, as far as I know, in that building. Dr. Brett Olson would be the same. And then Dr. Borus and Dr. Groom, Dr. Borus will be speaking a little bit later, are also, I guess, have spent their entire yet shorter careers in that building as well. So I think when we combine the clinics, because this is, you know, we'll tear down Spirit Lake Medical Center, Lake's Family Practice will also be vacated. So we also have to remember kind of the physicians who have been there as well. Dr. Steve Carlson is retired. Dr. Ken Clayton is retired, and Dr. Clayton has subsequently passed. Dr. Jeremy Beloit is retired family physician there. I see Dr. Baskerville in the back, who's transitioned to the ER. Dr. Tom Kalkoff spent most of his career there. And again, you have others, Dr. Meeting, Dr. Meyer, Dr. Vanderleest. In fact, Dr. Vanderleest, he was the first physician we recruited that I distinctly remember telling him, someday. And so excited about that. Dr. Mike Kalkoff, who I'm not seeing, the nurse practitioners and the other staff who will be moving here. I want to hold up a couple of our physicians as well that are retired, that really not only committed their careers here, but continue to commit their time and volunteerism here. Dr. Ford served on our advisory board. Dr. Curlin serves on our patient family engagement board. Dr. Rodwig was on the Board of Health for a number of years. Dr. Clayton was out before he passed. I did not know him, but he and Dr. Rodwig were very, I would tell you, kind in different ways. They would bring coffee into my office to give me words of wisdom. Dr. Clayton would allow me to converse back, and Dr. Rodwig would just leave words of wisdom with me. So thankful for their work, thankful for the physician's work and otherwise. So the new medical office building is really about the next generation of patients, the next generation of healthcare providers, and it'll be symbolic of the work that you all have done and we all have done, and that building will serve people long after we're gone. I heard somebody say once that the best time to plant a tree was 40 years ago, and the second best time to plant a tree is today. So that's kind of what we're doing. It's been 45 years ago when that tree was planted. We're going to plant a new one starting today. I want to acknowledge several people, and if I forget someone, please correct me later. First of all, I want to thank the USDA. For those that don't know, the USDA does investment financing for rural economic projects. And it's really thanks to them and a lot of their financing work that we're being able to do this project today. So I want to acknowledge and thank the USDA. They have representatives here. There are four local banks that have been very supportive of our construction financing: Bank Midwest, Northwest Bank, State Bank, United Community Bank. Some of those representatives are here today, and I want to thank them and thank them for their work. I also want to acknowledge Avera. For those of you that don't know, Avera Health and Lakes Regional Healthcare jointly own in a partnership the two family medicine clinics here. And so I want to appropriately thank our partner, Avera Health, for that. A lot of leadership, my board, or not my board, our board, the Lakes Regional Healthcare Board, a number of those folks are here today, and thank you for your work. I want to thank the community, the patients, the staff at all of the clinics, the patients in particular, for your patience. Your support of us, the extra block long walk that you have to take if you're a Spirit Lake Medical Center patient, thank you for that. We're just trying to look out for your wellness and making you walk a little further. Very thankful for the supportive community. We had a significant local planning group led by Steve Alger, our chief financial officer, Lois Hahn, Dr. Groom, Dr. Vanderleest, Gary Van Wettering, Amanda Plotty, Sandy Moses, Chris Ingram, Pat Holdorf. I see a number of our volunteers that also we've added to their pedometers in the last while as well, added a lot of additional work for them. So I want to be thankful to our volunteers. I also want to, because I see a number of nurses in the crowd, not that I would normally hold them out versus anyone else, but it happens to be Nurses Week. So if you're a retired nurse or a nurse, thank you for your service. And I just want to leave you with, you know, my sincere and deepest thanks. This has been a labor of love. This has really been a 10-year conversation. And I think anybody that's been here for the last 10 years can say, yep, been there, done that, heard that story, and really thought it wouldn't happen. And so I'm excited to see this come to a close, excited to see about what will be here for the next generation. Appreciate you all coming out, and thank you for your time. I'm gonna turn it over to Dr. Borus. Dr. Zach Borus is our chief of staff, and he's gonna offer a couple words. After that, I would encourage you to walk into the entrance of Spirit Lake Medical Center. There are 3D renderings, there's coffee, there's cookies, and otherwise. So thank you for your time.
Thanks, Jason. I, as chief of staff, over the last year and a half, got voluntold that I've got to speak to all of you. So thank you for having me. Really, this marks the end of one building and one era and the beginning of the next. And so I really want to thank a number of people for your support of this project and for committing many of your careers to this location and to this community. Jason spoke already about how this building has been here for nearly 45 years and how really some of the giants of the local medical community helped establish it and helped really bring us into the 21st century. So again, thank you for being here, Dr. Ford, Dr. Curlin. Thank you to those who cannot be here as well. It built a great foundation for where we are today and for moving into the next decades of care delivery. A number of thank yous for those who are supportive of this new building project. So the hospital leadership, Avera, the hospital board, Jason. So I came on the scene about 10 years ago as I started to be recruited, and I started 5 years ago. And yes, from the get-go, it was sort of a pipe dream that someday, maybe, if all things align, we will possibly come together as one group. Lots of ifs. So the fact that we are at this point today, that we are going to be one group, is it official? Can we tell the name? Is that allowed? So in about 14-ish months, we will be Lakes Regional Family Medicine. The two groups put together, and we are all incredibly excited. It has become a cohesive medical staff. We are already working together in ways that we haven't worked together before. And really, I think it's going to set the stage for how care is delivered in the coming decades. Healthcare is changing all the time. Healthcare is different from when I trained 10 years ago. It will be different again in 5 years, 10 years, etc. And this space, as Jason mentioned, is going to be incredibly flexible. It's going to allow us to reuse some of the space that's in Lakes Family Practice and use that for groups and for various other new models of care that we haven't even thought of yet. Be flexible as our staff grows, as we recruit new doctors, and it's much more attractive for new physicians coming out of training to really join into an established large practice in a brand new state-of-the-art building. So we have an incredibly excited medical staff. We are very happy to be finally getting going with this project after waiting a number of months, years, etc. Again, thank you to the patients for your patience and for all of your extra steps up to the new clinic, or to the temporary clinic. And I'll look forward to seeing you all at Lakes Regional Family Medicine in 15 to however many months it ends up taking. So thank you for being here today. Thank you for your support, and I appreciate it. Thanks.